Hello, and thank you for watching. My name is Rachel Barnett with Gentle Frog. I'm here to create videos for you to help you understand QuickBooks slightly better than you currently do. If you have any comments, questions, or suggestions, please put them in the chat box. Thank you.
In this video, I want to show you the Accounts Payable Aging Summary and just talk about what it is, how you find it, and what do you learn when you get there. I'm just starting with my dashboard. It doesn't really matter where you start. What you'll want to do is go to Reports on the left-hand side of your screen, and then select Reports in the pop-out menu. From here, you can scroll down to find what you want. I'm just going to take the easy route and search for it in the upper right-hand corner. So, if I search for Accounts, I can see my options, and I'm going to go to the Accounts Payable Aging Summary. When I look at this, I can see that I have three vendors, ABC, Ellis, and UPS. Each of them is owed some amount of money, and it's in the column of 91 and over. What this is telling me is that at some point I told QuickBooks, hey, we have some bills we need to pay, but we're not ready to pay them yet. Could you keep track of them? And QuickBooks is like, yeah, no problem. Then the second thing it's telling us is that these bills are more than 3 months past due. That feels kind of problematic. Like, I meant to pay the bills. Maybe I did pay them, maybe I didn't pay them. But right now they're being tracked in QuickBooks and they're showing that they're past due because they're more than 91 days from their due date. If I want to know more about the particular bills, I can click on the number. When I click on the number, I'll get a list. Now, in this example, there's just one bill per vendor. I now have my list of my bills. If I want to look at the bill, I can click anywhere on the horizontal line. So I can click on the date, the word bill, the vendor name, and so forth. When I click on this, it takes me to my original entry. This is what I entered into QuickBooks in order for QuickBooks to tell me, hey, you've got some money you owe to somebody. So if I wanted to make any changes, this is where I can make those changes. Let me go ahead and close this, and I'll close this. So now we're back to this. This is helpful, and it can be helpful if you're tracking your bills in QuickBooks. In the past, I used to offer Accounts Payable, where I would help the owner keep track of what bills they need to get paid, highlight the recommended bills that they pay, and then work with them either to print out the checks, and then I would mail them off, or use some sort of online service. I don't do that anymore, but I still want you to see how this could be useful. So let's go back in time. Let's pretend that we're looking this back in March. So I'm going to say, all right, show me these bills as of March. Now when I look at them, I can see there are some bills that are not yet past due, some bills that are less than a month overdue, and some bills that are less than 2 months overdue. When you change this as of, you're just saying, QuickBooks, show me a report that tells me what bills are due and approximately where they're at with their due dates. So this is a thing you can do. Let me show you another thing you can do. So I'm recording this video on December 9th. So do this as of today, and we'll say each of the columns, instead of being 30 days, let's make them 90 days. And instead of having four columns, let's make five columns. So you can just kind of customize it and see what's gonna make sense for you. What is going to be the most helpful information? It doesn't matter to me what you pick, it's just what's going to work. I know this video is all about accounts payable, but I want to show you one other report, a report that I think might be useful. So let's go over here. We know the people who get money, or the companies that get money, they're called vendors. If we search for a report and we just say, QuickBooks, show me everything you have that has the word vendor in it, we can look and see. So there's vendor balance detail. That feels useful. Vendor balance summary. We just saw a summary report. So let's look at the vendor balance detail. Now, what I can see is grouped up by vendor. Here's all the bills. Let's just add another one for ABC Corp because I want you to see how it would look if there was two. So I just added a bill for $120. So when you look at this, the difference between this and the report we saw earlier is you can see all the bills for a particular vendor. I like this because it helps me see what do I have going on rather than seeing the totals. When I'm thinking about what should I pay, I'll come here. When I'm thinking about was this already paid but recorded incorrectly, I'm going to go here. When the business owner says to me, hey, Rachel, how much money do I owe people? I want to pay off all of my bills. That's when I'm going to look at the accounts payable aging summary. And I can be like, okay, ABC Corp, you owe them $169, and then so forth. So this is a really good one to kind of see what's past due, what's the total. The other one is good if you're like, I need to see a super long list of everything there is. I don't know how many questions you guys might have about accounts payable. If you have other questions, please let me know. I'm happy to show you anything that I know within QuickBooks. I'm happy to make fake scenarios and make videos all day long. So just put it in the comments below. All right, thanks.